The world is divided and lays in broken heaps because man is divided within himself. The world is going to hell in a handbasket, and men are to blame, especially straight, white, traditional men in America and the West. There is no end to the amount of hate, blame, and victimhood directed at men today. Men, it seems, are the cause of a long list of tyrannies, oppression, and violence. And the victim groups who lay blame with men only seem to be getting stronger and more hysterical. If you are a man in America today, understand that you are hated. You're hated for your privilege. You're hated for your power. And most of all, you're hated for the very traits and behaviors that make you a man. In fact, a recent report by the American Psychological Association says that boys and men who exhibit traditional masculine behavior are at greater risk to themselves and others. They suggest that socialization practices, which teach boys from an early age to be self-reliant, strong, and to minimize and manage their problems on their own, may be to blame. Men are supposed to be strong, stoic, and self-reliant. What is wrong with men? Why do the very traits that make a man, seem to be the cause of so much concern? If everything that men have been for thousands of years is wrong, then why are doctors, schools, the media, and women trying to fix men now? The truth is, there is nothing wrong with being a man, especially a so-called traditional masculine man. When men are being men, boundaries are set, agreements are made, and great societies are built. When men are being men, risk, hard work, and devotion is valued. When men are being men, women are relaxed, children are happy, and the weak are protected. Men, when we are being real men, everyone in society wins, no matter what the establishment, media, or radical feminists say. Alpha men are the greatest leaders in this world. Without the risks, responsibilities, and sacrifices made by strong alpha male leaders, nothing in this world would be built. Weak-willed men and whiny women did not build America, nor have any angry, envious, hateful social justice warriors ever created anything good. All they do is eat, shit, complain, blame, and destroy. Alpha males, traditional masculinity, great men. Men who are willing to sacrifice and stand strong in the face of evil will always be the great leaders in this world. There is no such thing as toxic masculinity. Only men who have been misrepresented, miseducated, and misled. But all that is about to end. When our grandfathers were alive, before the breakdown of the traditional family, easy divorce and abortion, before fuck buddies, radical feminists, and fatherless boys, before skyrocketing suicide rates, attention deficit disorder, and incels, men knew exactly what it meant to be a man. Because older men, fathers, uncles, grandfathers, and family friends understood just how critical it was for young men to be mentored, mirrored, and informed about who they are and why they exist. Our great-grandfathers, ancestors, they understood that men of all ages have a primal hunger for meaning in our lives. Today, there are no safe spaces for men. Today, there are dozens of so-called victim groups who require safe spaces, a shelter away from harm. These people are often merely victims of other people's opinions and judgments. Safe spaces provide a container where these people can feel their feelings and fear their oppressors. But what about men? Men are under attack. And if you don't believe me, just take a look at what men have become in the last 50 years. The rate of male suicide is between 5 and 6 times that of females. According to the National Academy of Sciences, the increase in suicide among white males led to as many white male lives lost to suicide as have been lost to AIDS. Black males, while only 6% of the overall population, make up over 43% of murder victims. More black boys between the ages of 10 and 20 are killed each day by homicide than by the next 9 leading causes of death combined. What has been the establishment's response to this crisis of men? Prison. Prison spending in America has increased at 5 times the rate of spending per grade school student. The last I heard, the state of California spends around $75,000 per inmate per year to keep men behind bars. And it should also be noted that almost 40% of boys in America live in a fatherless home. If a boy does live with his father, there's a good chance the father is a beta male provider who acts like one of the kids with his wife. Just like the dads on popular culture TV and mainstream media, he's weak, dumb, and helpless. Men are literally becoming women. Free male hormones in our drinking water from birth control pill piss, they say. Estrogen compounds from plastics and pesticides are in the food we eat. This makes men more womanly and weak. Men are more emotional, skinny fat, and soft. Men are without meaning and without a mission. Men are without mature, masculine mentorships. The world is divided and is laying in broken heaps because man is divided within himself. Ralph Waldo Emerson.